Right, brace for boomerant. This one's important. They're all important, but this one especially annoys me. So here's what I can't stand. And this is gonna be an ironic video because it's gonna be me, an alleged Linux technology YouTuber, lecturing normies on how to behave in social situations. Because frankly, I am disappointed. I am disappointed at the behavior of so many people. So here is the issue. Let's say you're in a social environment. Let's say you're seeing old friends that you haven't seen in a long time. Let's say you're, I don't know, you're at a party, you're doing stuff. Here's what I cannot stand. I cannot stand it. When people, in a lull in conversation, if there's nothing happening for 2 split seconds, when everyone just gets on their cell phone. Like, oh, here I am seeing people in real life that I could talk to, but no, I would rather open up my cell phone and I would rather talk to imaginary people online, talk to people I'm not seeing. That is something I just cannot stand. When I see people, you know, I don't know, when I go to someone's house, when someone comes to my house, when like I'm at, I don't know, when I'm in social environments, it is just, frankly, I just find it rude. Because, you know, you wouldn't, if you're, you know, let's say I'm at my house and someone isn't entertaining me for every single second, I'm not just gonna go to my bookshelf and pick up a book and start reading. That would be so obnoxious. But for whatever reason, people think it's okay when you're like, oh, here, let me see what other people are doing online, you know? It's just so annoying. Now, I'm not saying that people do this all the time, but it's just the fact that that is a reflex is so annoying. I actually have a name for people like this. I call them incels, because they're always in their cell phones. Like, they view it like that's their natural, it's their default idle animation, okay? They're just looking at their cell phone if they're not doing anything else. It annoys me to no end. Incels, that's what I call them. And other incel behavior that annoys me, let's say you, like, go on vacation with some people, and of course, they're not there to actually experience the vacation. That's not what they're there for. You might be there for that reason, but they're not there for that reason. They are there to take pictures of the vacation so they can represent it online, so they can represent it on Facebook or Instagram or whatever. Okay? They're not actually experiencing the vacation. In fact, they will go to great lengths to make that vacation more boring so that they can put things online. It is so, like everything you do has to be like, oh, let's get a good shot of this. Every single thing has to be, it's like they don't actually experience life. They experience life through a cell phone. Okay, it's like things aren't real until you see it through that lens, or you see it until it's Facebook official, right? It doesn't actually exist. Okay, this is what annoys me to no end. Or another thing, let's say you're having just a normal conversation with, or what you think is a normal conversation with someone. Let's say, oh, you know, a random question comes up, like, oh yeah, who ran in the 1968 election against Nixon? Oh, I don't remember. Except for an incel, what an incel does is, oh, here's a question that isn't answered in our conversation. So I am going to break this conversation. I am going to pull open my cell phone and I'm going to take several minutes to look this question up. Okay, for that, for like seeing who ran for president, that might not take too long. But for some people, you know, some people will literally break conversation and spend like significant amounts of time looking up some kind of stupid, it just doesn't matter. Like, I'm not really asking, you know, it's a rhetorical question. I'm not really asking because I need to know this fact. If I wanted to know, I could look it up myself, frankly. I just want to have a normal conversation, and if we happen to not know that, that's fine. Get over it. Incel behavior, I cannot stand it. It is just so, can you just start living a normal life? The fact of the matter is that these people, incels, are not, like, they cease to be individuals. Instead, they are an external representation of, like, the Matrix. They're basically, like, they really represent curated Google search responses, okay? That's really what they are. They really represent their Facebook feed, their Instagram feed. Okay, this is what is so annoying to me, and that is what they view as primary. Like, and here's another funny thing. When something happens in real life, like something newsworthy or something like that, there's this idea that, oh, until I see it online, it doesn't actually exist. I might see it with my own eyes, mine own two eyes, but it isn't actually real until I see it on the internet. That is like extreme hyper-reality. That mindset is just like insane. You could like see someone, I don't know. It's just crazy how things are nowadays. Anyway, so stop doing this stuff. Stop being an incel. In fact, I don't even, I mean, you guys know, Like, I have a cell phone that I use basically to record videos, and sometimes I have it in my car in case, like, my, I don't know, my car collapses or get, you know, malfunctions or something like that. But I'm just utterly against, like, I don't take cell phones into any place where there are going to be other humans, okay? As far as I'm concerned, it's basically an emergency device. I really don't even need service on my cell phone now that I think about it. And I don't even get service. When I have people over at my house, I might have said this, like, it annoys me so much when people do incel things. Like, they'll just, like, look at social media or whatever. I just turn off my Wi-Fi when people are at my house because I don't even want them doing stuff like that. And luckily about my house, I don't even get, like, cell reception. So basically, you know, if I turn off Wi-Fi, there's nothing there. You know, you're just going to have to get over it. So yeah, just stop doing this stuff. It's so annoying. It is so, it's frankly rude. It's rude to, like, look at a cell phone when someone else is, like, sitting with you. Even if I know, like obviously it's rude on, like, a one-to-one date. People usually don't do that. I can't say I have that happen to me much, but, like, when you're in a small group of people, it just is so obnoxious. I don't know. I must be an old boomer, must be a literal boomer rant, because I'm sure that you Zoomers will be like, that's the most natural thing in the world. Whatever, you're wrong. You're wrong. Stop doing it. Just get rid of your cell phone, seriously. All right, that's it. Or maybe I should wait to 7 minutes. Or is it 7 or 8 minutes nowadays? Who cares? Whatever.